Hi, I'm April Yvette and welcome back. Thanks for tuning in. I've decided to start a brand new series and it's all based on a recent survey that I sent to my blog subscribers. I asked them, what is it that you would like to learn about? What are the topics that you're most interested in that will help you the most in your life or your business right now? So I gathered all of those answers together and I've decided to create a series out of it. So the very first topic that I'm going to be talking about is confidence. As a matter of fact, that was the number one topic that my blog subscribers chose, that they wanted to learn more about how to increase their confidence. You see, confidence is a powerful way of being. It is so powerful, it determines how many people will say yes to you. See, confidence is something that people feel instinctively, and in a conversation or even just being in your presence, they make specific decisions based on how you make them feel. And the more confident that you are, the more likely they are to say yes to you, you know, in any situation. So confidence can help if you're a mom, being confident trying to get your children to clean up their toys. Confidence helps if you're in a sales presentation, how to get that yes answer. Confidence also helps if you own a business. Maybe you're selling a product or service and you're looking to expand or sell more of what you have. Confidence is so important in every aspect of our lives. And it truly does make a difference in how your life plays out and the different opportunities and doors that open for you. So I'm going to talk a lot about confidence in the next probably few weeks. I'm going to share some things that I have learned about confidence. So let's get started. We're starting with the three levels of confidence. So the first level is really at zero, and I call that's where you have no confidence at all, and you're totally unlikely not to believe in yourself or believe in your product, service, or whatever it is that you're doing or selling or, you know, whatever the situation is. So unlikely is it is not going to happen, and you are definitely getting a no if you are at ground zero. As you move up to the second level of confidence, this is what I call on the fence. These are people, and myself included in the past, where I kind of believed in myself, or I kind of believed in my product or service or whatever I was doing, but I wasn't 100%. And maybe it's possible to put together a presentation that is perfectly rehearsed and sounds great, but if you secretly are kind of on the fence, you're definitely going to get a no answer in that situation, because even though your presentation sounds perfect and you've rehearsed it and you're smiling and you're doing all of those things, the decision makers can feel if you're confident or if you're not confident. And if you're not, they're more likely to say no to whatever it is that you're doing. Now, there's different degrees of level two. You can be at a 25% confidence level, a 50%, maybe a little bit more confident. Maybe you really think it's possible. That would be more like 75% confident that whatever it is you're doing should be a yes answer in that situation. Whether you're asking your boss for a raise, maybe you're in a job interview and you want to sell yourself to that company as the candidate that they should hire, you gotta walk in there with a high level of confidence, whatever the situation. So on the fence is level number two. Level number three confidence is so critical in life. It's what I call conviction. It's where you get to a place where there is absolutely no doubt. That's conviction. That level of confidence, conviction, is so powerful that you almost always get a yes answer in that situation, no matter what the situation that you're in. If you're walking in for the job interview, sales presentation, getting your kids to, you know, do something, any type of influence, if you walk in there with conviction and you are in that, you feel that inside, it's not just your words, you actually feel it, you're definitely going to get a yes answer. And that's where you're at 100% belief. You believe it, and it's truth to you. It's so you're so in belief of it that it's truth. That's what conviction is. I want to tell you a quick story how I got to conviction several times in my life. So conviction is 100% belief, as I said. So there was a time where I was working for a company, and I was responsible for generating sales leads for the entire sales team. And I remember that the company was going through kind of a tough time financially, struggling. There was a change in the market. My boss walks into my office, lays a paper, you know, corporate paperwork on my desk and says, "Hey, I need you to sign this, you know, whenever you get a chance." So I look at the paperwork, and it basically, what they decided to do was go around and give pay cuts. And I remember looking at that paper going, "Oh gosh," you know, I was really upset with that at first because I'd been working very hard for the company. So I sat there, and instead of complaining about it, gossiping with other, you know, employees, I decided that I was going to get my boss to say yes and say that he was not going to lessen my pay or my commission structure. That was my goal. So what I did was I printed off the last probably 4 months of sales information off of the company computer system. I looked at every month. I looked at how many sales I had and had generated for the leads and how much money that was sold based on my leads. And then I put together a lot of thank you notes or nice messages that I had gotten from referral partners or customers. So I walk into my boss's office and I share with him that I don't believe that my pay should be cut, and here's why. I went into an entire presentation that was about 15 minutes long. First, I shared with him the 7 thank you notes I'd received from referral partners and clients. Then I shared with him the computer printouts with the numbers circled for how many sales I had generated for the company. It was millions of dollars in the past several months that I had been in that position. And he looked at everything I presented to him. I had complete conviction that my pay should not be cut in that moment. It's because I believed it 100%, because I could see right there in black and white myself, and he could see right there in black and white that I was not just doing my job, I was working above and beyond to generate sales and be of value to the company. And he looked at the papers and he said, "Yes, I agree with you. Your pay should not be cut. Your pay will stay the same, and your commission will stay the same. Thank you for your, you know, contribution to the company." And I walked out. And I remember thinking to myself, you know, I could have just complained about it, signed the paper, and then been disgruntled, been angry and upset, had an attitude, maybe a chip on my shoulder. But I also want you to know that conviction happens when you're playing full out. If I was slacking and not making my sales goals, I wouldn't have had the confidence and the conviction to go in there and ask for my pay not to be cut. That's critical. You've got to show up. You've got to, you know, play full out and give 100% of yourself wherever you are in any situation. That's just one example. I've got many others I could share, and then other great stories that I've heard from other people as well about conviction. So I hope that this has served you today. What's important and what I want you to really get is that wherever you are right now, ask yourself, where am I with my level of confidence? Am I at a 0, which is unlikely? I'm just not confident at all. Am I on the fence? Do I kind of feel confident some days not so confident? Or am I at the conviction level to where it's 100% belief in myself and belief in my product or service, what I'm selling or what I'm doing? So the goal is to get to 100% conviction if you're not there. So over the next couple of weeks, I'm going to share with you exactly, step by step, what can take you to being somewhere on the fence for feeling like, yes, it is possible, to having complete conviction. And when you get to the level of conviction and belief, certainty, you're going to get more yes answers in your life in every situation. So thanks for tuning in. I hope this has served you. If you have any comments or questions, please type them below this video. And I always respond. I read those. I can't wait to hear from you. And we'll see you soon.